And that's how Snow White was rescued by her prince, and they lived happily ever after.
So what are they going to do for the rest of their lives?
They're going to live happily ever after.
I want to be happy, especially with all those dwarfs running around.
Come on, Nathaniel, it's a fairy tale. That's just what happens.
I'm tired of fairy tales, Grandpa Jake. They're all so boring.
Well, I do have this other story, but it's definitely not for the weak of heart.
Is it scary?
It's more than that. It's a story of triumph and truth, I know, because I was there.
So what happens in the story?
It's a complicated tale, so I need you to listen closely. I'm sure you've heard of Team Complexity.
Team Complexity? They're my favorite team in the whole world! How do you know about them?
My dear boy, I knew them very well, and I still know them today.
Wow, you must be famous, Grandpa Jake.
Well, that was a long time ago, but the team is stronger than ever.
That's amazing.
In the beginning, nobody wanted to believe. They said that it would be the end of the world before we'd ever amount to anything. They said it would be Armageddon.
Hi, my name is Justin Summy, alias Sunman. I'm 20 years old. I've been playing competitively for about 4 years, but 5 years altogether. Well, I've played baseball and soccer for about 6 or 7 years in a row. I think I get more of an energy vibe out of playing Counter-Strike professionally and winning big matches and stuff than I did when I was playing soccer and baseball. But I don't think anyone that doesn't play professionally knows the feeling whenever you win a big match in Counter-Strike, that it's really that big. I love competition, and that's what it is. The competition that gets everyone going when you're playing the team that's better than you, and you're the underdog and you beat them, that's when it really sticks out in your head. Those matches always stick with you forever.
Working up alternate middle right now between alternate middle and regular middle. Ion's getting boosted up in the window. Rank is working his way up into apartment. He's going to go ahead and turn down my endgame sounds real quick, guys. But we have a good round panning out in front of us right now. We got in the middle. Oh, Trip pushing up into the window room. Takes down Ion. Titus able to get a pick there. On to Trip. Score. Fires back on to Titus. Man, he gets picked down by Patel as well. Getting demolished there. Rekt is going to fire back on to Storm. Going to be just drawn here left at this bomb site. We got two members of Team Zex left to the second to Complexities. Three bombs going to get planted here by Hickey. Hickey and Rekt LMS. Four Team Zex. Rekt up in the apartments. Hickey's going to be back by middle. Still getting flanked here by Sunman. He's going to turn the corner. Flanked by Sunman. Sunman takes him down. He's going to get boarded. Up on the sniper deck. Rekt goes down at the hands of Sunman. Wasted there, destroyed.
In our match at UWC versus Now Sports, I was in a 2-on-1 versus Roman R and Neo. I planted the bomb in the lower site, and I ran to the doors quickly. Once I got to the bomb, it was already starting to beat pretty fast. I peeked out after I heard him defuse it, because there's two guys I figured one might stay on the bomb. Roman and I was defusing the bomb, and Neo was shooting at me through the glass door, and started shooting me through the wall, and headshot me twice. And then the last guy had no time to defuse the bomb.
I like to be the first into the bomb sites. I'm really a point man on this team. I like it. I like being the first one in. If I make my shot, we're gonna win the round. If I miss my shot, we're probably still going to win the round because I have four great teammates behind me. Pick up exactly where the guy is and take care of him without losing any more people. This professional level, each player on that team is just as dangerous as the next. I don't think we're like, okay, we killed Method, this round's over.
And Warden's gonna be last man standing here for Team Complexity, coming to the library, 88 health. He's trying to spot one and hit, three versus one, he drops Ions, looking for another one inside the box. There's another one, he takes it down. Titus, the last one is Rector.
I would give an example, like when I used to play baseball, when the ball's hit, you have to visualize there's a player on first, you're gonna throw it to second, to get the double play, and you can go first. You have to know what's going to happen. What am I going to do if the ball is hit to me?
In middle area, gonna go ahead and fake defuse. Rector has it peeked again. Towards the pit, he's up on the sniper deck now. Rector down to 37 health. Warden at 49. Rector's about to peek, taking a look here. Oh, Rector tries to spam him. He gets the defuse.
And then we started to attack Cat. Started off slow. Trip picked up a kill, and then we traded kills. I came up third, and Danny was yelling to run, so I started fading back, and I just remember a reaction shot on Drowley. Just flicked my AK towards him and hit him in the head. So I went to plant the bomb. I think it was a 3v2. So I needed Cat and was lucky enough to pick up another kill. And then SPX picked off Fraud, peeking as usual. And Sunman, was me and Sunman in a 2v1, so he started to spam me. And I just came around the box and shot him on the side. So relieving to be in a 1v1 and win, because that just, you're up 6-1 in the finals match for $40,000.
My role on the team is calling the team strategies. I've played hockey, I've played baseball. I've always wanted to win whenever I played anything, even if it's a video game. Every time I call a strategy, I know in the back of my mind that this could make or break the game. Every time I call the right strategy, it just reinforces that I'm making the right decision. In our match versus Kid Game, we played him on Inferno. It was a 2v3 with a bomb planted, and Fraud got picked off early. I knew I had to come out and try to get a pick, and I threw a fake flash, like it was a flash, but it was actually a smoke grenade. And then I peeked and I headshot the diffuser. And then Oligan came after me and I hid. If I would have peeked with 2 health, I would have got shot. I made footstep noises and I distracted him to get off the ball.
Terrorists win. I've actually played CS since the second day it came out. I've learned the game is less about reflexes and more about preparation, more about learning from past mistakes that you've made. You have to know your teammates very well. Most of us have been playing together for over a year now. I know all the moves that they're going to make on every map. I'm the type of player who likes to know my surroundings, know what's going on. I'm not like Matt or Danny, first guy in. I'm more of a cautious player. I check almost every single corner when I'm going in. I understand their gameplay. I know when they're going to be peeking corners, and I'm able to outsmart my opponents. I prefer it to be that way because I have the match or the round in my control and come back out when they're least expecting it. We bought Deagle Armor, as we normally do on our save rounds. I went to my normal strike box. I avoided some nades and flashes as they were coming up the middle ramp. I spotted one come up. And I spotted two of them there. I was hoping I could double them. And I spotted Sal on top of those boxes and killed him through the little pole. I felt awesome doing what I did, but I knew that it was because of my teammates that I was able to do that.
I'm normally around the second or third person to go in, mostly behind Warden. Warden's the one that he likes to go ahead and go first, but I'm the one that kind of initializes the attack.
Spam now being worked. Rector getting the drop there on Storm. That was beautiful, all the way over by the library there. Drops him. Ion's now pushing up to support him. Fraud! Nice! Drops Rector! That's an impossible shot and he pulled it up, sorry. Ion's now all the way into the middle of the bomb site. Trip dropping 1-2 for Titus. And then swivel around 180, drop him in the head. Once again, an awesome shot. Fraud though, 1-2
sweet Jesus, he just doubled somebody.
I think as far as hitting the shots go, I don't think it's necessary that I have a gift or anything. I have one shot to hit.
Into middle, up at the top by Dicky. Fraud with two MP5 kills, make it 3-4, Storm comes in with the last kill. And
the game against NIP was very back and forth, and it was one round, they went inside and they rushed it. We needed a momentum change in order for us to just grab those two rounds and help them to stop buying and stuff. We ended up getting a few picks, but it was a 1-on-3 with Heaton. You know, we had no idea where he could have been, so no one was really focused on CT spawn, because that was probably the very last place that I think that he would be. He could have easily killed all three of us and won the round for them. When he did that, I kind of heard it from the corner of my ear. As soon as I heard him shoot his bullets, I ended up jumping onto the little hitches in the train yard and doing a 180 to kill him. That shot basically like jump-started our whole team because everyone got excited about it, and then after that we won that round and then won the next round to win the game.
Counter-terrorists win. Practicing, dedication, that really made this team good. Complexity has a dedication. I I'd have to say the win at ESWC for Complexity is a massive accomplishment. I mean, winning a major tournament, there's nothing like it. I mean, you can come in second place a million times, but until you win, it's a totally different thing. And Complexity has now won, so I mean, the sky's the limit for them still. They're now our American team. Stay on top, and that should be Complexity's goal.
Created Complexity. You made them world champions.
Created the team? Yes. But made them champions? They did that themselves. And I'm proud of them.
I bet they're proud of you too.
Oh yes, I think so. But remember, winning isn't the only thing that's important. It's about teamwork and dedication.
Someday, I want to be just like them.
You can be. If you remember the things I told you. And that, my boy, is the moral of your bedtime story.
Grandpa Jake, wait. So just what happened after you left the team?
I sold the team to a man named Midway. And the rest, you could say, is history.
Gee, someday, I'll bet I'll be in Complexity.
That's great! Starts with an earthquake.
Oh, I told you, Corey's coming in.
I know, but still, not like that.
I just dropping the dust now.
That was insane, baby.
Okay, you and me died, and Justin died, and Tyler was still, didn't even kill anybody.
I was still in the library.
I was waiting for him to come out of the hall.
Tyler Wood, best player in the world. He's got one of the fastest Colts I've ever seen. Just look at that face. Determination. That's good! Right there! Justin Summey. This kid's got insane micro. Look at that face right there. It's ridiculous. Look at what he's doing. He doesn't even flinch. 100 APM. Kid's ridiculous.
The horse tranquilizer.
In the world?
Any
questions for me, Matt? Why do you talk shit in
lights, Tripp's computer was down, so it was time for me to dust off the mouse. After a couple of bad rounds, I knew it was time to pull out my MP5 of death and get my first Cal Invite kill. Although that was the only match we lost that season, it felt good getting that kill. At least now I can advertise Cali Experience when looking for a pug on IRC.
You can't turn the slowness on volume.
Good fortune.
Okay. If I ever end up in Complexity, I'll be G3 Master.
You did a great job. Will Cole go all the way? Vote. I'm going to vote yes.